Hey everyone, and welcome to today's video. Today's video is going to be about the workshop maps and how they can make you improve faster than, you know, some of these training packs would, or playing just regular matches would. You got to remember, regular matches, you're not getting the ball touches that you need to improve as fast as you would as if you were playing training or workshop. You get a lot more ball touches, therefore you're going to have a lot more time to control the ball and kind of get used to where what touches are going to put the ball, because you're the one who's making the touches. Obviously, playing regular matches is also going to be a very big benefit to you. But here we got the workshop map, and I think this one helps you improve your aerial control by a large margin. So here we got the workshop map, speed trials number 2, I believe. It's blue hoops. It's real nice looking. So basically, here's level 1, and obviously you can go backwards if you would like this the whole time. I'm going to go for my sake, because I'm not as good as some of you guys out there. I'm going to stay frontwards for the most part, and then maybe I'll throw in some backwards occasionally. Yeah. Here's round 2. We got level 2 here, not round 2. Here's level 2. Yeah, some of you guys are able to do, you know, if you can go backwards the whole time, that's going to make you insanely, you know, more consistent with backwards aerials. As I have about no practice with that. I do have some. Let's see how it goes this time around. We'll try it once here. I do need to continue to do some of these workshops to get better at backwards aerials. So I did it there. That wasn't one of the hardest levels, obviously, but, you know, it is somewhat difficult to go backwards if you're, you know, just trying for the first time. Good luck. It is difficult to get used to. But one thing I love about this map is, you notice I just hit the freaking post. Couple times there, I actually just hit the post. Now it's gonna send me flying. I could have recovered, but maybe no, I'm not gonna recover. But basically, hitting the post is kind of, you know, something that happens a lot in game. Actually, you know, if you hit somebody in the air, or hit, you know, the wall or the ball weird, you might just lose control completely. So hitting the post is actually a very similar feeling to an in-game feeling when you hit the, you know, hit the wall weird, or you hit another player in the air. So you can still recover in some of those. This will help you with that, I think. So it's really nice getting that in-game feel when you hit these loops. Another thing you can do, if you're a little bit more advanced, then you can go backwards the whole time, or you can freestyle through these, air rolling left and right. No matter where you go, you're good to go. Make sure you don't touch any of those, because that can make it a little bit more difficult. Like right there, I just touched that one. Obviously, I was messing around for a second trying to freestyle. But try not to touch the ring at all if you're really advanced as well. Then try to go as fast as you can as well. So up at the top, you can maybe see that little, that's 2 minutes and 6 seconds from me right now. But there's like a little timer up there. It kind of times how long you've been in it, how long you've been in the workshop map, and how long you've been grinding it. So you want to restart every time and see what your fastest time can be. That's another way to get, you know, great improvement. But I think this map just helps your aerial par control. I keep saying ball control, but helps your par control a lot. Just happening to fly through these hoops and then trying not to hit the edges, depending on how you're doing it. Then also, I mean, you got to change views sometimes. Mid-game when you don't want to, just to see what's going on behind you or beside you. And that's what that does. Look at the difference there of pressing Y. Because the ball respawns over here at the next island. So like I just completed 10. That means this ball over there, well, that was here, is now over at island 11. So if I die here, all that happens is I go back to number 10. So it's basically a checkpoint. But yeah, so one of the big things is just making sure to keep your control. And on these, I think it's number 10 right here. This one can be somewhat difficult for people if you don't take it slow. That hoop right there, it might not have looked that difficult, but it actually is very difficult if you don't take it slow. So going through these fast is a whole different story. Like, I can't explain how much harder it is to go fast. I've tried this workshop map a couple times. It's a ton harder. Right there, I just couldn't get up. I don't know if my mind blanked for a second, which, I mean, this map will make you do that after a while. It'll make your mind kind of blank out. It just did it again as I'm trying to go over. I really couldn't just find the right arrows. Right there, I'm struggling again. I think I'm blanking out a little bit. But you know, that's gonna happen when you're doing this a lot. Because I did have an attempt at a video earlier with the same map. It just deleted the video. So here we are, round two. But I made that right there somehow. But I'm trying to take this a little bit slower. You know what the main thing is? You just got to change your camera setting, or not camera settings, but your camera angle sometimes by pressing Y. I just clunked that, and I'm still going to make it. But yeah, you change your camera settings by hitting Y, and that'll help you out a lot throughout this course. And then you get your results at the end. I got 438, which is obviously not anything impressive. But so if you're looking to go for an impressive time, let me know what you guys get, because I know when I did mine, it was not impressive at all. Even when I try to go fast, it's just something about it I'm not able to, you know, think sometimes. I don't know why, but when I get up to some of these, I just think left is right and right's left, and I have no idea why. So it does get you a little bit foggy sometimes, but it really overall helps you a ton when there's, you know, those game decisions where you have to, you know, swerve in front of the ball midair, backwards or whatever else. Just freestyling on this map was also a big help. But yeah, once you're here, you just press the replay button like you're in free play, and it'll send you right back to the beginning of the map. And you can go for a backwards this time, or you can go for a speed time if you want, see how fast you can do it. But it's very, very helpful for improving. And I guess we'll do a little sneak peek over here. If you guys don't know, hitting those chairs, well, hitting these chairs right here, always a good time. But this big ball right here does move. I would suggest hitting it before you start the map. I'd do this at the end if you want to mess around with it. But it does move, so you can try to see what you can do with it. There's a volleyball net there too. Do a little air dribble. Obviously, it's going to be kind of uncontrollable, but you know, it is a mod, so there's stuff like that. And then, it, you know, if you go in the water, by the water, it'll send you back. So, all right, guys, I hope this training helped you guys out. Subscribe to see some more. We're going to have a little bit more coming to you guys in the future. Probably some more workshop maps that'll help you out, and some more training videos. We got that 1v1 series that's going to be coming back. I've had a lot of responses, good positive feedback to that, so I'll probably be bringing that back, episode 2. Yeah, this training workshop, or this workshop, is, you know, very beneficial to everybody that has tried it, in my opinion. I've talked to some friends and they all love it. So give it a go. Let me know your guys' results and times. If you can beat it, or if you got stuck on a level, let me know in the comments below. All right, thanks, guys. Thanks for tuning in.